In this video, I'll show you how to do load balanced sets with Linux-based services. I have two VMs running Linux, Ubuntu 13.10, and running LDAP, and I have seeded different LDIFs in those VMs, so you can see that the first one has 01 and the second one has 02. I'll use this to show you how the load balanced set work. You can set a load, you can create a load balanced set using the command line interface. You can do it from the management portal as well. So you go to the first VM, you enter the management interface for that specific VM, and you go to endpoints. So you're going to create an endpoint just like any other type of endpoint. It's a standalone endpoint. In this case, we're going to use LDAP, which is 389, so it's TCP 389. But you'll click in this button saying create a load balanced set. We're going to define a name for this, let's say LDAP LB01, for example, and we can use several types of proof protocols. We're going to use TCP 389, we have 15 seconds, we can bring this down to 5, for example, number of proofs before deciding that the endpoint has been lost. And so we create the endpoint for the first one. And then after this endpoint has been created, and as I mentioned, you can do that on the command line interface as well, you can go to the second VM, create a new endpoint, but instead of adding a standalone endpoint, you're going to choose an existing load balance set. So before doing this, you have to make sure that the endpoint has been created. And on the command line interface, it's also important to mention that all operations with load balance sets, including creating endpoints and attaching existing VMs to those endpoints, need to account for exclusive operations that Windows Azure has. So parallelism needs to account for that as well. So when you add the endpoint, you choose LDAP LB01, which is the one that I already created. And then you just go next. You can specify a name for this one. We're going to just choose LDAP as well. You can also, depending on the type of service, you can also enable direct server return. In this case, we'll have it false. And after you create this, if your VMs were connected, meaning that there's like an entry IPv4 address that you can use for this, and your second VM does not necessarily have a dedicated IPv4 address, so you can check this by reviewing the first VM you created, and you have a port 22 for SSH, and the second VM should have a higher port for SSH, meaning that they are sharing the same virtual IP address, even if they have different internal IP addresses, and this is going to be the same for LDAP. So what I'll do now is use a VM that is not running on any kind of Azure infrastructure. This is an other internet connected server. And we want to use LDAP to query the virtual IP address. So we're going to get the root account for this cloud service, and we're going to show you what the results are for the specific string that we created. So as you can see, the load balance is working automatically by using just the management portal. And I can shut down specific VMs, and after the timeout and the number of proofs that we set, it should be working correctly. Now, I can do the same for, this is just for OpenLDAP, but I can do this for other types of services that could be clusterized. I have done that for MySQL in this example. I have created a load balance set for MySQL as well, and I have set up some specific clusters infrastructure using CoreSync and DRBD and Pacemaker. So as you can see, I have a two-node cluster that is a shared nothing closed cluster using a file system that runs on top of DRBD. We have a master and a slave. We have fencing set up using Azure command line interface, meaning that if StoneIt needs to be used, we can use the Azure command line interface to actually shut down, start, or restart a VM. Basically, the functionality of this, it's about the same as the LDAP service. So if I can use an external server to query this, I can call MySQL to the specific cloud service that I have, the virtual IP address. I can get the results. Right now it's the master, the one on the left that it's that has been started and it's working. So what I'll do now, it's basically just shut down this VM, and let's do that with the management portal. So I'm gonna go to HADV01, which is the one that is active right now, this specific VM, and I'm gonna shut it down using the management portal. It is already dead. So now we have a switchover, and as you can see, the master is gonna become HADV01, part of my clone set. There's also gonna be a stoned check that is gonna be initiated on the VM on the right. As you can see, MySQL has been started on 02, and the file system and DRVD as well. And after the time that we have set up for this specific endpoint, which I think it's around 15 seconds, our queries have been restarted. So as you can see, you can use Windows Azure, load balanced sets, and the shared nothing architecture with DRVD, CoreSync, and Pacemaker, for example, to deliver Linux-based, clusterized solutions in the cloud.